Hello, welcome to this movie, and today I will show you how to perform analysis of trabecular bone structures. So first, please open the dataset here, and let's close the segmentation, because we can create it ourselves, close segmentation. So what you see here is a part of a bone of a sheep knee, actually. And you can see the trabecular structures here. And if we hover over them, we can see the intensity here down there. And so let's pick a threshold to segment the bone parts, add a class bone, for example, and pick some threshold between the bright intensity and the dark intensity, something like above 4000. And now you can see the bright voxels were segmented as bone only, and you can see that it's a bit too noisy actually, because there are all these small spots. So let's undo this and apply a Gaussian filter with one, for example, and now we can perform the thresholding again. And now it looks better. So now we don't have these small spots everywhere. So let's look at the bone in 3D. Here it looks a bit like a toast. So you can see the trabecular structures. And what you can see here is that there are different regions here at the side. We have more, it looks more spongy. We have these big gaps. We can measure the distances between the bone walls, 0.75 millimeters, and here the spacing, that's what it's called, is much lower in the middle. And on the other hand, you can measure the trabecular thickness here and maybe here. And so with this bone module here, you can measure these structures, the trabecular spacing and the trabecular thickness, for example. But for that, we need to define a region. Here, let's just measure some size like this to get an idea, 4 millimeters. So let's add a class A here and place a cylinder. Diameter 4 and length 4 millimeters. And here we can add a class B and also add a cylinder. So 4. Oh, sorry. That was too quick. Cylinder with diameter 4 and length 4. So now we can select one of them as input class, A for example. And then with the bone module here, we can tell it to compute the trabecular thickness. We have to enter the threshold that we use. And the trabecular thickness of class A is 0.025 millimeters, centimeters, sorry. And we can do that for B as well. Or we can compute the trabecular separation here, also called spacing. Or we can compute it for all classes at once using this menu. Oh, we have to remove the unused classes. Again, bone statistics. And it's computing it here, and it shows here the trabecular thickness and spacing. And the thickness is actually quite similar for these two regions. But the spacing here is thicker for A than for B. As you can see here, the spacing is thicker here than here. So how does this actually work? What the software does, it's computing a so-called local thickness map. I can do this here for class A. It's showing this as overlay now. And it's fitting a lot of small spheres actually into the bone region here, and then it's computing the mean of that. And in a similar way, we can compute the local thickness map of the trabecular spacing. Then it's fitting these spheres into the spacing and computing then the mean of that. And that is the same how BoneJay does it, and we compared this software also against BoneJay, and it correlates very nicely. You can also here create some test data sets, like a true, like a sphere, or here multiple spheres. And that, because for these examples, the solutions can be computed analytically, and it's a nice example to test if the software is working correctly. So you can see the parameters, they are similar between the known and the computed versions. And so what this example is just an array of a lot of spheres, and we know the surface of these spheres, for example, and their thickness. And then for the bone module, there's also a batch mode, and that works nice in combination with the batch menu, which you can learn in another video. Okay, then thank you and bye-bye.